Hello all, my name is Manoj Mathew. I am going to explain about Data Envelopment Analysis or DEA. A DEA is generally used to measure the performance efficiency of a set of entities or alternatives, popularly known as Decision Making Units or DMU. I'll explain DEA in context of MCDM, that is Multi-Criteria Decision Making. This is a decision matrix containing different alternatives, but in DEA these alternatives are known as decision making units or DMU. Basically, DEA model employs the concept of system efficiency, which uses output or input for determining the overall efficiency of a DMU. In DEA, non-beneficial or cost criteria are known as input, while beneficial criteria are known as output. An alternative or a DMU is considered inefficient if it fails to attain maximum output and minimum input. In MCDM also, we desire to have minimum input value, which is a non-beneficial criteria, and a maximum output, which is a beneficial criteria. Most of the DEA models assign a score of 1 to the efficient, that is the best DMUs, with respect to other inefficient DMUs. Before proceeding further, we have to normalize the decision matrix. This is done using this formula. I have shown you how to calculate the denominator. This denominator is calculated using this formula. You can see here, the denominator is calculated by taking root of the summation of square values in the column. So I have taken the square of all these values, added them and taken the square root. Next, we divide the value with each value in the column. So here you can see that on solving, we will get these values. Although there are several DEA models, I'll tell you about CCR model. This model was first introduced in 1978. The basic fractional CCR model is a non-convex programming, which is very tough to compute. So Chance in 1978 developed a linear programming model of CCR. This linear programming or the linear program model can be articulated either by maximizing output or minimizing the input criteria. In the example, I have taken a minimization of the input criteria. We calculate HK, which is the efficiency measure of the kth DMU. Let us look at the nomenclature of the linear programming model. You can pause the video and write the formula so that you can use this while formulating the problem. Now, here N is the number of alternatives. In this example, we have 4 alternatives, so N will be 4. M is the number of input criteria. Now, here you can see that there is only one input criteria, that is price. So the value of M will be 1. S is the number of output criteria. There are 3 output criteria, that is storage space, camera and screen thickness. So the value of S will be 3 here. Values in the first column are the XIK values, while the values in the second, third and fourth column are the YRK value. Now, UR and VI are the non-negative variable weights to be determined by solving the minimization problem or the linear programming model. Let us first evaluate the first DMU, that is mobile 1. I have shown here the linear programming model of it. For first mobile, the value of K is 1. In CCR model, we only consider the input criteria for formulating the objective function. So here you can see that I have only considered the input value of the first mobile, that is 0.04735, for formulating the objective function. Here V1 is the weight of input criteria, that is price or cost. U1, U2 and U3 are the weights of the output criteria, that is storage space, camera and screen thickness. You can compare the formula and the linear programming model which I have formulated here. Objective function only contains the value of input criteria for the particular alternative which we are evaluating. In this example, we are evaluating mobile 1. So the objective function will only contain the input value corresponding to row 1. Now if we have multiple input criteria, then we will have the summation of all those terms. That is the weight into, this is Vi is the weight into the value corresponding to that alternative or input criteria. You can see the constraint formula. It have the negative summation of UR, that is U1, U2 and U3 into your YRK value. These are the YRK values, the values in the second column, third column and fourth column. These are the YRK values. So here we have 4 DMU. So we will have 4 constraint equation corresponding to each row. So these are the values of YRK, and this is the value. The value in the column 1 is the XIK value. So here you can compare the formula. Next we will look at the equality constraint. We only consider the value in the first row because we are evaluating the first DMU. So these are the YRK, that is the values of YRK for the first DMU. We just take the summation value and equate it to 1. Similarly, for the second DMU, that is mobile 2, LP model will be this. You can compare. The only change will be in the objective function. In objective function, the Y value will be replaced by this value and the equality constraint. In the equality constraint, you will use all these values. Similarly, for the third DMU, that is mobile 3, the linear programming will be this. So here you can see that I have, in the objective function, I have used this value, and the equality constraint, I have used all these values. Similarly, for the fourth DMU, that is mobile 4, the linear programming will be this. I use MATLAB linprog function for solving the linear programming model. I have shown here the syntax used for linprog. To solve using linprog, we need to rewrite the equation. I have introduced u1, u2 and u3 in the objective function and v1 in the equality constraint. I have changed the inequality constraints. You can see here the difference between both the constraint equation. You can pause the video and see all the changes which I have made. This is the standard format for solving the linear programming model using linprog syntax. Then after that, you need to create 7 metrics, namely F, which is the objective function, A, which is the coefficient of U1, U2, U3 and V1 in the left side of the inequality equation. So these are the values. Small b is the value on the right side of the inequality equation. AEQ are the coefficient of U1, U2, U3 and V1 on the left side of the equality equation. Similarly, BEQ is the value on the right side of the equality equation. LB and UB are the lower and upper bounds of the variable U1, U2, U3 and V1. So here you can see that all these values should be greater than 0, but the upper limit is not defined. So you will create a null matrix or an empty matrix for UB, that is the upper bound. This is the MATLAB interface. You need to create 7 matrix in the workspace. I guess all of you know how to create a matrix in the workspace. If you don't know, I have given a link in the description below. You can watch that link to understand how a variable can be created or the matrix can be created in the workspace. So I have created here all the required matrix in the workspace. You need to type this. You just need to type this and click enter, and it will automatically solve. Now these are the values of U1, U2, U3 and V1. This is the value of V1 and the value of G1. You can see here the value of G1 is 1.0329. To calculate the value of H1, you need to take the inverse of G1, that is 1 by G1. So this is the value of H1. Now you can change the function value, that is this F matrix. You can just change these values, function value and the equality equation, that is AEQ. You can change these values and calculate the value of G2, G3 and G4 and corresponding value of H2, H3 and H4. In CCR model, a DMU is considered efficient if it achieves a score of 1. So in this example, mobile 2, 3 and 4 are efficient. So we can select either of the 3 DMUs or alternatives. That's it. Have a nice day. Please do subscribe my channel and also press the bell icon so that you may get notified whenever I upload a new video.